Alexa, turn on nano aquarium light.
Okay.
A video on IoT based aquarium can be expected soon. So, subscribe and stay tuned. Hey YouTube, in today's video, I'm going to show you guys how to make a carbon dioxide generator for your aquarium. So, let's get started. For this project, first we will need a container that can store high pressure gas. For that, I am using a 2-liter soda bottle. Next, we need to make a hole in the bottle cap in such a way that the gasket is intact. For that, I am using a 15mm hole saw drill bit. I am using 1-inch PVC end cap to connect the tubes. In order to attach the end cap onto the bottle, we need a piece of 1-inch PVC pipe. The bottle cap is slightly bigger than the pipe, so the pipe is heated to get the correct fit. Next step is to glue the parts. For this, I am using epoxy glue. Next, we need to connect the tube. The tube is of 6mm diameter and it is usually used in RO filters. You guys might be thinking, why I didn't connect the tube directly to the bottle cap but to the end cap. It is because the end cap is rigid and stronger than the bottle cap. L-shaped push-fit connector is used to connect the bottle to the outlet tube. Next, we need to make a hole in the tube present inside the second bottle to prevent the backflow of alkali. Okay, so this is the setup. First bottle contains citric acid and water. Second bottle contains baking soda and water. Citric acid reacts with baking soda to produce carbon dioxide. The first bottle is squeezed to start the reaction. As the acid enters the second bottle, carbon dioxide is produced. Carbon dioxide produced in the second bottle travels to the first bottle through the hole made in the tube. This process is repeated till both the bottles get filled with carbon dioxide and becomes tight. Now the valve is slowly opened to release the high pressure carbon dioxide. In the next video, I'll be making a carbon dioxide diffuser with bubble counter. So subscribe and stay tuned.